Okay, so here we are, little beech plantation here within the forest. This is where I'm going to set up my tarp. The main reason for this video is this is a brand new tarp. It's a DD tarp, 3x3. I used to have a larger one, which I brought to Canada with me on my recent trip. But I left it there for my brother, as he was finding it hard to find stuff. So. Thought I heard somebody coming through the woods there, but obviously not. So let's go set up this tarp and I'll show you some of the knots I use when doing so. There's my pack there leaning up against that tree. I'll find somewhere to set up this camera. As you can see, it's still quite misty. Rain started again, so let's get this up. Okay, so I've selected my spot here. I've found two trees that I'm going to attach the main ridge line of the tarp to. So first thing I need to do is quickly check the trees and make sure that there's no dead branches up there. But if I start shaking it, it's going to fall down and hit me in the head, because that'll be sore. Looking good. So I've got the tarp here in the top of my Alice pack. DD tarp, 3 meters by 3 meters. I haven't even had it out of the bag yet, so I'm hoping there's no holes in it. And some brand new paracord. This is a 550 paracord 7 strain. 100 meters here, so that's plenty for what we're going to do today. Forgot about the pegs. Okay, I've got the tarp laid out on the ground there, and the paracord, that's all untangled, and it's ready to put up on the tree. Now obviously once I get this done once, the next time I come to put the tarp up, I'll not have it laying on the ground like that. But I'll show you the way I fold it at the end here. So first thing we're going to do is attach one end to this tree to the right, and I'm going to use a knot called the Evank Hits. Okay, this is also a quick release knot, so when you're finished, you just get the running end and pull it like that. That comes out. Very good knot to have in your knot armoury. Okay, so I'm going to try a close up of the Evank Hits. Strap around the tree, hold the running end in your right hand. Take your left hand, wrap the run round, or the running end, sorry, round, down, over. With these two fingers, you want to pinch the running end and pull a loop through it. Pull that nice and tight, and then put it through the tree. Okay, now that end's secure, we want to secure this end, and we're going to use the taut tarp hits. Okay, so you're going around the tree. Pull that nice and tight. Over the top. And then go around the opposite way. Bring this over the ridge line. Create a loop. Pass it up that little triangle there. Pull it tight. And then with the running end, create another loop and pass it through the first loop. Again, make sure everything's nice and tight. Like the Avant kits, this is also a quick release knot. So now we've got the ridge line set up, I can move this up and down it. But obviously we want to keep this in place, keep it nice and tight. Another notch used for that are called prusik knots. And I'm going to put a couple on and then hopefully I'll do a close up for you. So I've already attached a prusik knot onto that side of the tarp. So now it's just this side. So I'm gonna get this nice and tight. Okay, so just take a bit of paracord and just fold it in half like that. And where you've got the loop, put it on the opposite side of the ridge line. Fold it over towards you. Pull the two strands up and over. And then do it again, and then I always like to do it a third time. Okay, so when you've got them two strands there, they're still in the middle, and where you start it is on the outside, and then you just tighten that up. Just tidy it off. There you have your prusik. You can move that up and down. Okay, I'll try and zoom in and I'll do that a wee bit slower so you can see it. For those of you who don't know how to do it. So what's left to do now is attach paracord to each corner of the tarp so we can peg it out, and then that's your shelter done. So we'll take four lengths of paracord, these are about 2.5 meters long each. Attach it to each corner using a half blood knot. So take the paracord, feed it through the eye of the tarp. And you're going to wrap this five or six times. Around the standing end. And then pass that through the loop there. I think I've done that right. All you fishermen out there, might have something to say about it, but it works for me. Okay, so now we've attached the paracord to each corner of the tarp. So what we need to do now is secure that to the ground. I'm going to use the pegs that came with the tarp. Normally I just make my own, but I might as well use these while I've got them. Okay, and to attach the paracord to the peg, we're going to use the slippery adjustable loop. So we'll put the peg into the ground. Go and take your paracord, wrap it around the peg. Come back up slightly. Just move that a little bit. Take the running end, wrap it around the line once, then twice, and then the third time, wrap it around both lines. Create a bite and put it through that loop. And you pull that tight. Okay, now you're able to move that freely up and down your guy line. Get it nice and taut. Okay, that's it ready to sleep under. So there you go guys, that's the end of this little video. I suppose it's my first, what do we call, instructional video. This one's setting up a tarp, hopefully there'll be many more during the year. So if you have any comments, any feedback, any criticisms you want to leave, just post away on my YouTube channel or indeed my Facebook page and I'll answer them as soon as I can. Thanks for watching. All the best for now. See you again on the Nook Bushcraft.